Hindenburg exploded early morning, May the 7th, 1937. It was bombed by the anarchist Black Cross. Now, there were only two casualties, a journalist, Kate Drummond, and the man whose body was unable to be identified.
Okay, so to you, this is what's in the books. This is how it went down.
Of course.
And the anarchist group, three suspects who escaped from jail and vanished without a trace?
Yes.
That was us.
What?
We got some issues.
Flynn wanted a lot more than two casualties. He wanted to murder everyone on board, and we stopped him, but the Hindenburg, it wasn't supposed to happen like this. Flynn still changed history and in ways, I don't know yet.
Did you see him?
I spoke to him.
Really? What did he say?
He said I should ask you why you chose me and what Rittenhouse means.
I have no idea what he's talking about. I don't know.
Rufus, where's Flynn now?
The lifeboat CPU says that he's back in present day, but who knows where.
And so we can't go back to 37, give it another shot?
No. Remember, we can't double back to any place where we meet ourselves. There are no do-overs.
So what is Flynn after?
I have a theory. Any anti-government whack job can get a few barrels of fertilizer and blow up a federal building. It's not going to really change anything. Our institutions are too established, but in the past, things were a lot more fragile. I think Flynn is trying to kill America in the crib. Rewrite history before it's even written.
None of you are to say a word about any of this under penalty of treason. If we need you, we'll call you.
Wait.
Need us?
Nothing has changed. Flynn is still out there. He still has the mothership, and you are still our best option. When he uses it again, we will call you.